Hello everyone, welcome to Clear IAS. In this video, we will be discussing about various regulatory bodies in our country. I am Ujwala Pulela, an educator at Clear IAS. Introduction. So what are regulatory bodies? So as the name itself indicates, these bodies are responsible for regulating the various sectors in the country. So they set the standards and they also enforce those standards. They are part of the executive branch of the government, and most of them are empowered through legislative action. So in this video, we will be covering the regulatory bodies briefly, and separate videos regarding the various important regulatory bodies will be made on this channel. If you have already been made, please check them out. So the first one here is Reserve Bank of India. The Reserve Bank of India was established on 1st April 1935 through the Reserve Bank of India Act of 1934. It is India's central bank and is fully owned by the Government of India since its nationalization in 1949. The central office of RBI is in Mumbai. Structure. The affairs of the RBI are governed by a central board of directors appointed by the Government of India. The board consists of a governor, not more than 4 deputy governors, 4 directors representing the regional boards, 10 other directors from various fields, and 2 government officials. Functions. It formulates and implements the monetary policy of the country. It acts as a regulator of the financial system. Manages the foreign exchange according to the Foreign Exchange Management Act, that is FEMA, of 1999. Besides the Government of India, RBI is the one authorized to issue banknotes in the country. It acts as the banker to the banks. It regulates and supervises the payment settlement systems. Performs a developmental role to achieve the national objectives. Quantitative tools: statutory liquidity ratio (SLR), cash reserve ratio (CRR), open market operations which involves buying and selling of the securities by the RBI, bank rate, which means this is the minimum rate at which the RBI lends the money, repo rate, reverse repo rate. Reverse repo rate is usually 1% less than the repo rate. Marginal standing facility, that is MSF. MSF is usually 1% greater than the repo rate. Qualitative tools. Margin requirements. This is also known as loan to value. That is, consider you need a loan of 1 crore rupees and for the same you have pledged your collateral. However, if the RBI fixes the margin requirement say at 60%, then what happens is for this value you will be not getting any credit. That is, you will be granted a loan only of 40 lakhs. Rationing of credit and regulation of consumer credit. Through these two tools, what the RBI does is it controls the amount of credit available to various sectors. Also, the need of the down payments can be lowered or higher through these two tools. Next one is moral suasion. Through this tool, what the RBI does is it suggests or it gives suggestions and influences the decisions of various banks. So now let us understand the most important tools with the RBI, that is SLR, CRR, repo and reverse repo. As we have seen, SLR stands for statutory liquidity ratio, that is, this is the percentage of liquid assets, that is say gold and other RBI approved securities which the banks keep to themselves. Whereas CRR, as the name itself indicates, stands for the cash reserve ratio, that is, this is the amount of the cash reserved by the banks with the RBI. By these two tools, RBI controls the amount of the money which is available for lending purposes from the banks to the public. So suppose consider the bank has 100 rupees and the SLR as fixed by the RBI is 20 and CRR is 5. So after subtracting these values, the amount of the money available by the from the banks to lend to the public is 100 minus 20 minus 5, that is 75. So in the case of inflation, what RBI does is it increases the value of the SLR as well as the CRR. Now the SLR has been increased to 30 and the CRR has been increased to 10. So after subtracting these values from 100, now the amount of the value, the amount available by the banks to lend to the public is 60 rupees. So what happens here is the amount in the hands of the public will be reduced. So the demand for the goods and services will be reduced. So the prices of the goods will ultimately fall and the inflation will be kept in check. Repo. Repo is the amount of the interest paid for the short-term loans by the banks from the RBI. Reverse repo is the exact opposite of that. That is the amount of the interest paid by the RBI for the amount it borrows from the banks. In the case of inflation, what RBI does is it increases the repo value. Reverse repo is not directly increased or decreased by the RBI because reverse repo is dependent on the repo value. That is, as we have seen, reverse repo is usually 1% less than the repo rate. So by controlling the repo rate, the value of the reverse repo automatically changes. National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, NABARD. It was established based on the recommendations of Sivaraman Committee on 12th July 1982. Its mission is to promote sustainable and equitable agriculture as well as the rural development. The headquarters of NABARD is in Mumbai and it is fully owned by the Government of India. Functions. It serves as an apex financing agent to the institutions promoting rural development, to refinance the institutions in rural sector, to monitor and evaluate the projects it refinanced, to coordinate the activities of all the institutions engaged in rural financing, to provide training for the institutions working in the rural sector, to regulate and supervise the cooperative banks and regional rural banks, to help in creating linkages between the self-help groups, to promote projects under Integrated Rural Development Program. Small Industries Development Bank of India, that is SIDBI. It was established on 2nd April 1990. It provides refinance facilities and short-term lending to the industries. It strives for the promotion and development of the micro, small, and medium industries and acts as the principal financial institution of this MSME sector. The headquarters of SIDBI is in Lucknow. Functions. For refinancing loans to small-scale industries. It helps in expanding market channels for the products of small-scale industries. It helps in technology upgradation. It helps in the promotion of the employment opportunities. Discounts and rediscounts the bills. Ensures timely flow of credit to the small-scale industries. Providing services like leasing, factoring, etc. So let us here understand what is meant by discounting of bills. Consider there is a seller and a buyer here. The seller sells goods to this buyer, say to the tune of 1000 rupees. However, the buyer does not have this money of 1000 rupees to pay to the seller as of now, but he is confident that he will be able to pay this amount to the seller, say within a period of 2 months. So here a bill will be raised between the seller and the buyer. Say this seller is in need of money as of today and he cannot wait for a period of 2 months for this money. So what he does is, here he goes to a bank with this bill and asking for the money from the bank. So what this bank does is, it does not give the full amount of 1000 rupees to the seller. It charges a fee or say it discounts the bill and say it will be giving only 950 rupees to the seller instead of the 1000 rupees. So how is the seller benefiting here? He is getting the benefits because he is doing his business, he is selling his goods to the buyer and also he is receiving the amount. How is the buyer getting benefited here? He is getting the goods from the seller, and also when he does not have the money, he does not even have the problem that he has to pay the money to the seller beforehand. He got the period of 2 months here, after which he can pay the money. So here both the buyer as well as the seller will get benefited through this discounting of bills. National Housing Bank. NHB was set up on 9th July 1988 according to the National Housing Bank Act 1987. It is an apex level institution for housing finance and its headquarters is at New Delhi. Objectives: to promote a sound housing finance system catering to the needs of the population. To make housing credit affordable to all the segments of the population. To supervise the activities of various institutions serving the housing finance needs. To channelize the resources for promoting this sector. To create a network of various housing finance institutions. Securities and Exchange Board of India, that is SEBI. SEBI was established on 12th April 1992 according to the Securities and Exchange Board of India Act of 1992. It is the regulator of the securities and commodity market in India. SEBI has its headquarters in Mumbai. Structure: the affairs of SEBI are managed by a board consisting of a chairman nominated by the Government of India, two members from the Finance Ministry, one member from the RBI, five members nominated by the Government of India. Functions: to regulate the securities market and to protect the interest of the investors in the securities. To approve the laws relating to the securities exchange. To list and delist any company from the stock exchange. To take steps to prohibit insider trading in securities. It has the powers to compel the companies to list their shares in more than one stock exchange. It has the powers of a civil code in dealing with any malpractices on stock exchanges. It has the power to access all the records of stock exchanges and check their working. It can register and regulate brokers and other middlemen. Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India, that is IRDAI. It was established through the Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority Act of 1999. It has its headquarters in Hyderabad, Telangana. It was formed according to the recommendations of the Malhotra Committee. Composition: IRDAI is a 10-member body consisting of a chairman, 5 full-time members, 4 part-time members. They are appointed by the Government of India. Functions: to issue, renew or cancel the certificates of registration. To protect the interest of the policyholders. To specify the qualifications and provide requisite training for the insurance agents and intermediaries. To levy fees and other charges. To specify the form and the way the books and statement of accounts are to be maintained. To regulate the investments by the insurance companies. To supervise the tariff advisory committee. To undertake inspection, conduct inquiries and audit of the insurers as well as the intermediaries. Promote the efficiency in insurance business. Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, that is TRAI. It is a statutory body formed under the Telecom Regulatory Authority of India Act of 1997. It is considered as the regulator of telecommunications sector in the country. Its headquarters is in New Delhi. Functions: it is concerned with regulation of telecom services and tariffs in the country. It strives to provide a fair and transparent environment so as to enable a level playing field for all the players. The administration of TRAI is carried out through a secretariat headed by a secretary. An amendment to the TRAI Act in 2000 separated the adjudicatory and disputes function from TRAI and placed them in Telecom Dispute Settlement and Appellate Tribunal, that is TDSAT. Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority, PFRDA. It is a regulatory body formed in the year 2003. Its role is to regulate the pension sector in the country. Its headquarters is in New Delhi. A new pension system was introduced by the government based on the recommendations of OASIS, that is Old Age Social and Income Security Report. This was notified as NPS, that is National Pension System, which came into effect from January 1st of 2004. This NPS is also regulated by PFRDA. Medical Council of India, MCI. It was a statutory body established in 1934 with the aim to set high medical standards in the country. It was formed under the Indian Medical Council Act of 1933. Functions. To establish uniform standards for undergraduate medical education in the country. For accreditation of medical colleges. To recognize medical qualifications. For the registration of all the doctors and to maintain a Indian medical register. Current status. Based on the recommendations of Niti Aayog, MCI now stands abolished. It is now replaced by National Medical Commission, NMC. Financial Stability and Development Council, FSDC. It strives to maintain financial stability and works for financial sector development. The idea of such a regulator was first given by the Raghuram Rajan Committee in 2008. The chairperson of the council is the Union Finance Minister. It aims to provide financial literacy and attain the goal of financial inclusion. The reason for the formation of FSDC was to bring greater coordination between various financial market regulators. Biodiversity Authority of India. It is a statutory body formed in 2003 under the provisions of Biological Diversity Act of 2002. It functions under the Ministry of Environment, Forests and Climate Change. Its headquarters is in Chennai. According to the provisions under the Act, various state governments have created State Biodiversity Boards, SBBs. Functions. To strive for the conservation and sustainable use of biodiversity. To advise the state governments in the field of biodiversity conservation. To deal with the transfer of intellectual property rights related with indigenous knowledge related to biological resources. For attaining the goal of fair and equitable sharing of biological resources. Press Council of India, PCI. It is a statutory organization formed in 1966 and operated under the Press Council Act of 1978. The council is headed by a chairman, generally a retired Supreme Court judge, and consists of 28 members. The objectives of the council are to protect press freedom in the country and to strive for improving as well as maintaining the standards of press. The complaints against press are accepted by this council. It investigates such complaints and issues reports. However, it has no power to impose penalties. Central Pollution Control Board, CPCB. It is a statutory body established in 1974 under the provisions of Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act, 1974. It is also empowered with the functions under the Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act of 1981. Its head office is in New Delhi. Functions. To improve the quality of air and water. To coordinate the activities of state pollution control boards by providing them with guidance and assistance. To advise the central government regarding the issues dealing with water and air pollution. It runs the National Air Quality Monitoring Program to provide information on air quality. It also regulates and controls the noise producing sources. Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, FSSAI. FSSAI is a statutory body established under the Food Safety Standards Act 2006. It is headed by a chairperson appointed by the central government. Its headquarters is in New Delhi. Powers: to frame regulations for food safety standards, framing of guidelines for accreditation of food testing laboratories, to promote awareness regarding food safety and nutrition in the country, to advise the government regarding food safety and standards, to contribute for the development of the food standards. Central Board of Film Certification, CBFC. It is a statutory body formed under the provisions of Cinematograph Act of 1952. CBFC comes under the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. The certification by CBFC is necessary for the films to be publicly exhibited. Its headquarters is in Mumbai. Categories of Film Certification. There are four categories of film certification in the country. They are U, that is Unrestricted Public Exhibition, U by A, that is Unrestricted Public Exhibition but discretion required for children below 12 years, A, that is Adults, S, only for any special class of persons. Mission: to provide a healthy entertainment and recreation to the public, to make use of modern technology for certification process, making the certification process to be transparent and responsible, maintaining transparency relating to the various activities of board, to make CBFC develop into a center of excellence. Board of Control for Cricket in India, that is BCCI. BCCI is considered as the chief governing body of cricket in India. It was formed in 1928 and has its headquarters in Mumbai. BCCI is considered as the richest cricket board in the world. It has its own constitution defining the rules and regulations to be followed. The domestic cricket competitions are organized by BCCI. Advertising Standards Council of India, ASCI. It was established in 1985. Its headquarters is in Mumbai. ASCII ensures the protection of consumer interests and enhances the confidence in advertising. The advertisements must adhere to the ASCII code and any grievances are addressed by the Consumer Complaints Council. Central Drug Standard Control Organization, CDSCO. CDSCO functions under the Directorate General of Health Services, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. It is the central drug authority and performs functions assigned to it under the Drugs and the Cosmetics Act. Its headquarters is in New Delhi. Functions: CDSCO is responsible for approving of new drugs and conducting clinical trials. It also has regulatory control over the import of drugs. The Drug Controller General of India within CDSCO is concerned with regulating pharmaceutical and medical devices. The DCGI is assisted by Drug Technical Advisory Board and Drug Consultative Committee. National Association of Software and Service Companies, that is NASSCOM. NASSCOM is a non-profit industry association. It was established on March 1, 1988. And has its headquarters in New Delhi. NASSCOM's membership includes companies in the business of software services, products, BPO services, and e-commerce covering from startups to multinationals. It strives to accelerate the digital transformation through encouraging the advancement of research in software technology. Directorate General of Civil Aviation, that is DGCA. In the field of civil aviation, DGCA is the regulatory body governing the safety aspects. Its headquarters is in New Delhi. Its vision is to promote safe and efficient air transportation. Functions: to register civil aircrafts, issuing of license to pilots, aircraft maintenance engineers, air traffic controllers, and flight engineers, conducting investigation into aircraft incidents, to keep checks on the proficiency of flight crew. To carry out amendments to the Aircraft Act and aircraft rules. To grant approvals to institutes engaged in flying training. To grant approvals to aircraft maintenance, approval, design and manufacturing organizations. To grant air operator certificates to Indian carriers. To advise government on matters related to air transport. To keep a check on aircraft noise and engine emissions. To promote indigenous design and manufacture of aircraft and its components. To formulate standards of airworthiness for civil aircrafts registered in the country. Competition Commission of India, that is CCI. CCI was formed on 14th October 2003 for enforcing the provisions of the Competition Act 2002. Hence, it is a statutory body because it is formed according to an act. Its headquarters is in New Delhi. It consists of a chairperson and six other members appointed by the central government. Objectives: for creating fair and healthy competition in the economic activities. To protect the interests of the consumers and work for their welfare. To eliminate practices having adverse effect on the competition in the markets. To create public awareness and provide training on the issues related to the competition. Inland Waterways Authority of India, that is IWAI. It is a statutory authority formed under the Inland Waterways Authority of India Act of 1985. It was formed on 27th October 1986 for regulating of inland waterways. Its headquarters is in Noida, Uttar Pradesh. Its function is to build infrastructure on these waterways and undertake projects for the development. Few important national waterways. National Waterway 1, the Ganga Bhagirathi Hugli River system between the Haldia and Allahabad. National Waterway 2, Sadia Dubri stretch of Brahmaputra River. National Waterway 3, Kollam Kottapuram stretch of West Coast Canal, Udyog Mandal Canal and Champakara Canal. National Waterway 4, the Kakinada-Puducherry stretch of the canals, Bhadrachalam-Rajmundry stretch of the river Godavari and Wazirabad-Vijayawada stretch of the river Krishna. National Waterway 5, the Talcher-Dharma stretch of river Brahmani, Jionkali-Charbatia stretch of East Coast Canal, Charbatia-Dhamra stretch of Matai River and Mangalgadi-Paradeep stretch of Mahanadi River. So that's all for this one. Thank you all for your patience. See you all with another video.